on the road again, going places that I've never been, seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again, on the road again.
Welcome to the Palm Beach Cardinals and Jupiter Hammerheads Road Trip Show here on Roger Dean Stadium TV. I'm Lisa Fried from Space Ghost Stadium in Viera, Florida, home to the Brevard County Manatees. Now coming up on the show,
I can't wait to get on the road.
Life on the road, from bus rides to the hotel to the ballpark and everywhere in between. You'll experience what life is like for these minor leaguers. And the wheels on this bus go round and round for two round trips from Jupiter to Viera. You'll meet the Cars and Sharks' personal bus driver. Then later in the show, you'll see why the ballpark is called Space Coast Stadium. So now it's time for a liftoff here in Viera, where the Palm Beach Cardinals arrived first to play four games against the Manatees. But it was more than just the sea cows that the Cardinals had to battle. It was also the heat and rain.
It was scary. I was in the stands doing charts the first night, and lightning will light up the whole sky, and we're all jumping, and the fans are leaving, and then we come back the next day, and the sun's out. We get dressed, and then we come outside, and it's just pouring down rain, and it's flooding the dugout and everything. So we knew we weren't going to play yesterday. When they finally called it, we kind of expected it. After that, we kind of went back to the hotel and played FIFA and MLB The Show in my room. We had like a little tournament. All the guys got together and kind of hung out, a little team bonding.
With the rain postponing one game, you might think the players have extra time to maybe visit the zoo. It's only a block away from the team hotel. But in reality, the players have little time to play tourists.
Life's a beach. Oh. Life's a beach.
I didn't know a lot of those things were here until you just told me. We kind of don't even think about those things unless we have an actual off day. It would be nice to be able to go and visit things like that in Cocoa Beach and around the area. Hotel, ballpark, we're out to eat, and then that's basically it. It's baseball time.
You really don't get a chance to do too much. It's pretty much spend your day at the field and then go back, get something to eat, and try to get some rest. I have family that lives in Merritt Island, so get a chance to go over and see them, and they can pick me up for dinner. And it's been great. It's always nice to see family in season. I'm lucky being from Florida. Some of these guys are away for a long time.
So finally, it's getaway day for the Cardinals. That's the last day of the series where the team packs up and moves out of the hotel and the clubhouse after the game. But first, the players are pretty much roomless and have nowhere to go until game time. So they spend much of their time here at the hotel in the lobby.
That's so big.
Oh, wow. Oh,
big league.
Big league.
Big league.
I've heard. Yeah,
sometimes the bus won't leave till 5:30, and we have to be out of our rooms at 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. So a lot of downtime. You just put your stuff in the lobby and kind of chill out. And, it's nice that it's not just one person. The whole team's down there, so you can find something to do.
I never understood why people give outs to each other. There's a scoreboard the size of Texas in every stadium.
Back here at the ballpark, the Cardinals were cheered on by loyal Redbird fans.
Go Cardinals!
They're the best team in the world.
I never really root for a specific team when I'm watching a baseball game, but now I do have somebody to root for.
My wife and I are from St. Louis, and we've raised our kids to be Cardinal fans. St. Louis has got one of the greatest, systems to move through in the minors, so I'm hoping, keep my fingers crossed, that some of these guys make to the bigs.
When can we expect you to come up to Roger Dean and root for them?
Next spring, we'll be there.
When did you start following the Cardinals?
When Harry Carey and Gabby Street were doing the radio broadcast advertising Greasy Dick beer. So it's been a few years. These are players that I kind of like to pick up their names and see them when they move to Springfield or Memphis, because used to live in Memphis for 20 some years, and so I watched the Redbirds there.
It's going down.
yelling to me. You better move, you better dance. Let's make a night you won't remember. I'll be the one you won't forget.
After the doubleheader, the Cardinals packed the team bus and they were headed home to Jupiter. But the same bus driver is coming back here to Space Ghost Stadium the next morning, this time bringing the Jupiter Hammerheads.
We'll be going back to Jupiter and we should be getting back in there if everything goes right around 11:30, 12 o'clock tonight. And then I'll go to my hotel and the kids all go home. And then tomorrow morning, I'll get up late tomorrow morning and I'll pick up the Hammerheads. And they're gonna come right back up here and they're gonna spend 4 days doing the same thing. I'm keeping the room tonight so I don't have to move everything out because I'll be right back here again tomorrow. But I'm used to, you know, quick turnarounds every day. You know, I bring them in one night and head out the next morning with the other team. Now for the last two seasons, I've driven nothing but baseball all summer, both teams full time. The year before that, I did one team full time and the other team part time, but you know, pretty much 6 months out of my year are devoted to baseball. Today's the St. Louis cap. Tomorrow I'll have a Hammerhead cap there. Got to be loyal. Like a parent that has two kids, which is your favorite kid? You love them both. So I really don't have a favorite.
I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again.